शरणं गच्छामि संघं शरणं गच्छामि। मे ऑल द डिवाइन पावर्स फ्रॉम ऑल द डायरेक्शंस ऑफ द यूनिवर्स मे काइंडली लुक एट अस एंड शावर देयर ब्लेसिंग्स ऑन ऑल ऑफ अस। प्लीज अलाउ मी टू शेयर फ्यू वर्ड्स हाउ वी हैव बीन इन्वॉल्व इन दिस कोविड रिलीफ प्रोग्राम ले एंड कोविड रिलीफ एंड द अदर प्रोग्राम टू कंट्रोल एंड फाइट एंड विन कोविड 19। वी स्टार्टेड इन अ हम्बल वे। वी आर वेरी स्मॉल पीपल, स्मॉल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, बट बींग पार्ट ऑफ द बिग गवर्नमेंट एंड बिग सोसाइटी इन आवर ओन हम्बल वे, कीपिंग द मोटो ऑफ आवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कंपैशन इन एक्शन, मेडिटेशन इन एक्शन, वी स्टार्टेड आवर कोविड रिलीफ प्रोग्राम बाय ऑर्गेनाइजिंग ए स्पेशल ग्लोबल प्रेयर अंडर द बोधि ट्री एट बुद्धगया, द होलीएस्ट ऑफ द होली प्लेस फॉर द फॉलोअर्स ऑफ लॉर्ड बुद्धा। दिस प्रेयर वॉज डेडिकेटेड फॉर द ओवरकमिंग ऑफ दिस घोस्टली कोविड 19 वायरस। एंड वी वर वेरी लकी, इट वॉज जस्ट बिफोर द लॉकडाउन वी मैनेज टू गेट मोर देन 700 बुद्धिस्ट मंक्स, नन्स एंड ले पीपल फ्रॉम सेवरल साउथ ईस्ट एशियन बुद्धिस्ट कंट्रीज टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस स्पेशल प्रेयर। एंड आफ्टर दैट हियर वी ऑर्गेनाइज द कोविड रिलीफ आइटम्स सच एज राशन्स एंड अदर्स पीपी किट्स एंड अदर्स मेटीरियल थिंग्स लाइक दिस थिंग्स इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ लद्दाख लास्ट ईयर एंड दिस ईयर ऑल्सो। आई थिंक वी कवर मोर देन फ्यू थाउजेंड्स फैमिलीज। वी फोकस स्पेशली इन द बॉर्डर एरियाज एंड अदर्स रिमोट विलेजेस। Beside that, you know, last year while we are having this, the biggest war with COVID pandemics, unfortunately, very serious tension was built up on the Indo-China borders. These two countries almost got ready for full-fledged war. It was so frightening. While we are having the biggest war in the world against the COVID pandemics, we cannot think of having another war with our neighbors. So we also organize a peace campaign in all the border areas. Myself with my team visited all the holy temples and holy mountains in the border areas and offer our sincere prayer for the de-escalations, for the peaceful solutions, not for war. And that time we also carried few truckloads of relief items to the remote villages, because those villages in border areas, because of the war like atmosphere, very much neglected, about nobody is there to go there. And here also in Leh, we organized with the religious leaders for the prayer, and we send a strong appeal to our leaders of our country and the peace-loving people around the world to raise their voice for a peaceful solution and stop somehow war. And if this goes out of control, the war goes out of control and breaks out war between these two gen countries in Asia, India and China, which both of them are well equipped with this very dangerous destructive weapons, the consequences we cannot even imagine. Yes. So serious. So we receive a very good response from the country and around the world, and we are very happy that at least we do not claim that because of our prayers that the situation got little calm, but we are very happy with this. And Then we, in our own humble way, we continue and different programs on online. We offer meditation, yoga, and others teachings, counseling people how through yoga, meditation, and prayer of compassion can control or overcome the fear and anxiety and the insecurity. People, everybody was so scared and they don't know what to do, you know. And that is the best time actually to do meditation and prayer, yoga also. Besides that, sir, in our own humble way, we also organize an honoring ceremony to the frontier warriors, the health department, the police department, and the government and other NGOs. We have organized the honoring ceremonies. We have collected some funds donation. We have offered some funds for the medical department, the police department to buy whatever urgently emergency required. That was very humble. Our contribution is like drop in the ocean, sir. But then there is a saying, sir, there is no ocean without drop. Many ocean comes through. many drops makes ocean.
Yeah,
like that way. In our own ways, sir, we have been trying to do what we can. And then we also managed to get over 80 oxygen concentrators all together, more than 80. And out of that, 35 we have distributed in other states, mostly in Bihar, Buddha Gaya, and other places. And out of that, 25 we brought here, and we already distributed some 10-15 oxygen concentrators in some organizations, some health centers.
That was our theme of the prayer, the Buddha Gaya, from Corona to Karuna.
Yeah, that can be a theme. And it's a follow-up theme.
Sir, it is a honor for me to have been invited here on this occasion where the Mahabodhi International Meditation Center donated 25 oxygen concentrators to the health department. Though we already have quite a good number of them, but these additional 25 oxygen concentrators will go a long way in ensuring that the people who need oxygen to treat themselves in case their lungs start failing because of a disease or presently COVID, they would be benefited a lot. And I hope that these are deployed at the places where power is available, and they are also included in the normal system. We have to mark them, and we have to GPS marking should be done, because there is a system, sir, that any equipment that we have, it should be marked and it should be entered in the portal so that the Government of India and the Ministry of Health Family Welfare, they know where this particular equipment is lying at present so that it is properly used. So please distribute it quickly to the to the centers where this is required. And we are highly thankful to the Mahabodhi International Meditation Center for having provided us the facility of using their Mahabodhi Karuna Hospital premises for dealing with the COVID patients. And as Bhikkhu Sangh Sena ji mentioned, that it is a collaborative effort, it is an effort of the whole community to help themselves, and we always strengthen each other. And that the most important thing is that we must have compassion for each other, which we call Karuna. This is the right word, though there is no, can't be any exact translation of the word Karuna. It is such a deep meaning word, but the nearest English word would be compassion, empathy that humankind has for any living kind. It is not only the humankind that we should be compassionate with, but it should be with all life. Because we always see, sir, that we always see the Buddha symbols with animals, like with deer, with trees. And it is said that when Lord Buddha got enlightenment under the peepal tree at Bodh Gaya, all the leaves of that tree turned green. Whatever yellow were there also, they turned green. Because ultimately, as Jagdish Chandra Basu has proved, that the trees have the same sensations, some same feelings as humans have. So this very important part of the humanity is karuna, that we should have towards each other. And all living beings respond to it. I have seen it, that the, you know, whether it is even a snake, or even it is a small, you know, even if you are your pets, or for that matter any animal, if you love, they respond equally, you know, back. So this karuna is very important, and with karuna we can defeat all the miseries which visit us. I visited the hospital. We have been using it, and we have already, the HLG has issued clear instructions. I think you have got the assessment done, and you would be making the payment for the so you can make it out of the, as you make for the hostels. Whatever facilities are further required for that hospital to turn it into a better, you know, because ultimately if there are, suppose if for an example, if sir, if 500 patients visit the SNM, so if 200 of them go and visit a equally good hospital around it in Leh, certainly it will also bring relief to our doctors and our system. So because we in Ladakh don't have a private hospital infrastructure, so we all are dependent upon the government infrastructures, and that is also only up to the district level. So it is in our interest to develop the Karuna, Mahabodhi Karuna Hospital, in the Heart Foundation Hospital. At least these two come to my mind, that whatever assistance we have, we can give to them in the shape of machinery and equipment, we should give it to them, so that they act as, you know, as the alternate places where people can go and seek treatment, thereby reducing the load on the our normal mainstream hospitals, which we government hospitals. So all this should continue, this cooperation with such an enlightened person, with us, a noble soul. We all feel blessed, because whenever you sit in the company of noble people, people who are full of compassion, karuna, you feel very comfortable, and it basically brings you a lot of peace. And we are lucky to have such a wonderful institutions. I visited there. Those who haven't, I can tell you that I have not seen such good orchard in whole of the Ladakh. You have around 100 varieties of apples. I don't know, maybe I'm telling a little less, but maybe there are more. See, wonderful apples, wonderful trees growing in that part, in that, you know, it's, you know, seen to be believed. I mean, you can't believe that. And these things grow with compassion. I can tell you nothing I have in my life seen, that there are some people who plant trees and they actually survive, and there are many people who plant so many trees but they just don't survive. I think there is a connection between the sapling and the person who is actually planting it and maybe watering it, because the plants also respond to the person who is planting them. I mean, it is so natural. So I have seen some people have a knack of it. I mean, they have a hand, good hand, which if they do any grafting, it becomes successful. I may try 10 times, but every time it fails. So this is the compassion inside, I think, which gets transmitted to the plant and the plant responds. So this is the reality of life. I have some interest in the, you know, in reading. I read a lot, but and my own understanding is that if anybody has understood the secrets of this universe, it is the Lord Buddha. I think he is the only one who has given us an scientific explanation of what universe is, because he says that, correct me if I am wrong, but my impression is that he says that this is it. I mean, there is no point in arguing how it came, where it will go. So it's like a circle, you know. Everything is ends in shunyata. I mean, this is the reality. So with this compassion, which we must have for each other, and we should work, because the job of the medical people is exactly what Lord Buddha, you know, and any great people like Jesus would do that. A leper would become, you know, disease free. Lepers would become disease free when he would touch. A dead man would rise with his touch. So these things, people who are in touch with the God, who are in touch with the reality, their touch is miraculous. You know, so that touch should be in the doctors, in the nurses, in the people who help each other. So thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I feel honored to be with you here today and in your presence. And thank you once again for having donated these 25 oxygen concentrators. And many, many thanks for your continued cooperation and inspiration and encouragement to us to deal with this present challenge which the world is facing, that is of COVID pandemic. So thank you very much.
Please allow me to, students, would like to thank you so much for, you are very, very motivating, very inspiring and very encouraging words. Thank you so much.